I'm telling y'all, legend.
Legend. You called the knockout too.
Yeah, I called the knockout because you can't do what this guy do and not be great at what you do and not come back, man, with vengeance, bro. You can't come back from a suffering a loss and not get better, bro. This guy is a guy that's willing to take risks from the start of his career. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, you gotta understand that, man. It's a different type of mentality these type of fighters have. This guy is special. He truly is, and he showed that tonight. I mean, he made Nakatani look average. You know, I know the size and the punching power and all that stuff. Yeah, you gotta be worried about that, but the footwork, I knew the in and out, the IQ was just too much. That's why I said he's gonna stop him. I said, you don't stop him. Y'all must have forgot who the hell Lomachenko is. So we easily to jump off the bandwagon once a guy loses. But what did he do beforehand? So anyway, great performance by Lomachenko. Vintage Lomachenko. Loved it. I think that the Lopez fight got a little bit more interesting. I don't know if you saw, Loma started quicker. He started quicker. Normally he takes time and download, and I was hoping he was taking his time against a puncher like Nakatani, but he didn't. He took the necessary risk. He was like, nah, you're not gonna knock me out. I'm gonna be right in front of you. I'm gonna move. I'm gonna do whatever I need to do. Got in position, outside position, that front foot step shuffle. Woo, beautiful tonight, man.
Yes.
Yeah, best. Never seen any. In all my years of boxing, guy, nobody does it better than that. You know what I'm saying? I wish I had the chance to show you my top five offensive movers of all time, but Ali was the best of all time.
It was like Nate the dog, yeah. Nobody does it better.
Yeah. And of course you got Pac too, right, but right. You know, Loma's in that top five best offensive movers of all time. Of course, I gotta have Marvin Hagler, yep. A Hagler, switch hitter, you can switch lefty, righty, and then I have Salvador Sanchez at number five.
Yeah.
If you don't know nothing about, yeah, it doesn't matter, he died young.
Greatest Mexican fighter.
But like I always tell people all the time, you know, greatness, there's no age to it, bro.
Right.
There's no age to greatness. He died at a young age. We can just see how far he can go, but he beat some legends coming up.
Suzuma Nelson, Wilfredo Gomez, he knocked off legends.
Come on, bro. He's unbelievable. So, and then I also had, who was it?
Bro.
Manny Pacquiao. So it was Pacquiao, Loma. Ali. Loma's number four. Okay. I got Loma at number four. So right in front of Salvador Sanchez.
And lastly, Tim, thanks always for your time, man. Who do you think wins the rematch? If the Lomachenko that showed up tonight fights that way against Teo, or is in that type of
I can just tell you this. Just put it this way. He fought a one-fisted fighter tonight. One-fisted fighter. So he was able to move and get on that angle. He's not going to be able to do that against Lopez. Lopez is smart. He's already know where he needs to be. I think Loma's going to pick up the intensity. I think he's going to start sooner. And he's going to try to put Lopez on his back foot and have to make some smart choices. But Lopez, he's double-fisted, bro.
Yeah, does he make him walk into something trying to fight like that?
So a couple things can happen. Either Loma can have success coming in, and he will have some success, but he's going to have to take those risks. And if he gets caught coming in with a big shot from Lopez, either left hook, right hand, it's going to be trouble, bro. I smell trouble. So I don't know who's going to win the rematch right now. I mean, great performance by Lomachenko. He displayed all of his skills tonight. But Lopez is no easy challenge, bro. No easy challenge. He's beat him once. He can do it again. Lomachenko makes the proper adjustments to start quickly like he did. Don't never know, man. It's probably the first time you had me. I'm probably going to say 50-50.
Right.
Because I really don't. I really tell you who I believe is going to actually win the fight. And sometimes I'm right, sometimes I'm wrong. But at this point right now, after witnessing what I just witnessed, I don't know. I really don't know. We just got to wait and see what happens. And I don't know. If I do a little bit more studying. Studying
gotta
tonight.
Tapes, right? Yeah.
Got to do a little bit more studying. But I still see some of the same openings that Lopez was able to exploit. I still see it. Uppercut was there a lot of times. Left hook was there a lot of times. Stopped him from turning. Right hand, he got caught with some right hands coming in, being aggressive. So Lopez still got everything he need
to win the fight.
Yeah, to win the fight. Now, if Loma starts sooner, does he wear on Lopez? If he doesn't get hit or doesn't get hurt, does he wear on?
Or does he get caught?
And Loma, trust me, he's been dreaming about Lopez every single damn night.
He was fired up tonight.
Bro, he started quickly. He started fast.
He never does that.
I've never seen Loma start as quickly as he did. And then his footwork was even more dynamic tonight because, of course, he had the right guy in front of him. Slow foot, long, not a whole lot of movement, not a high IQ, just a tough guy. Just a tough
great
guy.
Spirit.
You gotta have, man, you can have great spirit and be a tough guy, but you're gonna get your ass whooped a lot of time. You gotta have skills. You gotta have skills. It don't matter if you, hey, you can be a small, hey, you can be a small, no doubt, though. You can be a small guy and have all the skills in the world, bro. You can take advantage of guys that are tall, lanky, and tough.
Right.
Bro, murder, no, tall guys was nothing for me. I enjoy fighting taller guys. So Lomachenko, all the skills he got more skills than I ever had. No brainer, bro.
Thank you. Thank you.
See y'all later, man. But yeah, great performance by Lomachenko. I'm glad he's back. Vintage looked great. And I know the fans at home, they enjoyed seeing what they saw.